Hello my dear students, my lovely welcome to Gurudeva e-learning class. Dear students, I hope that everyone are finding your home right? Very good. So you are studying well, right? Very fine. Okay. So already we have completed the two topics in the English subject. Okay. Today's class we are going to learn one more concept. Okay, that's a new concept. So before starting the class, I would like to ask you some questions. Can you answer me? Fine. Okay. See, I will show you some pictures. You can watch that and you can say the name of that. Okay. See, look here. Which picture is this? This is the picture of S cat. Very good. Okay. Now you can see which picture is this? Can you say now? S. This is the picture of dog. Okay. So this is a pet animal. Cat is also pet animal, right? Fine. So now you can watch another picture. So which picture is this? Yes, this picture name is cow. Okay, this is a domestic animal. So everyone are keeping in the home. So which picture is this? This is the cow. Okay. Now you can watch another picture. Which picture is this? Yes, everyone have known, right? So that is a picture of tiger. Okay, this is a forest animal. So it is living in the forest itself. Okay. So now you can watch the other picture. Which picture is this? Yes, this is the giraffe. Okay. So giraffe is the tallest animal, right? So it lives in forest. Okay. Now you can see another picture. Yes, which picture is this? This is a picture of dinosaur. Okay. So already have known in the first semester, right? In the so big poem. So this is the picture of dinosaur. Now we can't see that animal. Okay. So finally now you can watch this picture clearly. See, observe now. Which picture is that? Yes, that is a camel. Okay. So how is it look like? You can watch this. So this is the camel, right? I hope that somebody has seen that. Okay. So that is also pet animal also. Okay. Because somebody are keeping in home also. Because that is useful to the man. Okay. Have seen the camel? If you did not see, you can watch this picture. Okay. So now you can see one more picture. Look here. Okay. So in this picture, how many camels are there? You can count and tell me. Okay. There are 10 camels in this picture. Okay. So dear students, okay, what did you do now? So you have counted the camels, right? Fine. So here is the lesson, that is the counting the camels. Okay. So that I showed the camel picture. Okay. So what is the lesson name? Look here. Lesson number 3, counting the camels. Okay. So this is the third lesson. So today's class we are going to learn some interesting words. And you are going to learn how to read the lesson. And you are going to know about the author. Okay. And you are going to know about the camel also. So now everyone open your textbook and open the page number 28. So this is the third lesson, counting the camel. Dear students, who has written that lesson? Because all lessons and poems are written by the author and the poets, right? Yes. So this lesson is written by the anonymous. See, anonymous means unknown person. We don't know their names. Okay, such persons, they are writing the story, right? So we are calling them anonymous. Okay. Anonymous means unknown persons. So that they did not give any information about the author. Okay. So this story is related to the camels and the man. Okay. So I will tell you in the next class that. So now I am going to tell about the camel.
Facts of camel. The camel is a big and useful animal. Second, they live in desert areas. Camel is a courtship of desert. Fourth, it can live without water for many days. It has a hump on its back. Sixth, they store food and water in their hump. It is able to walk for long distance in desert. Eighth, camel has a long neck and long legs. People used to sit on the back of camel for riding. 10. Camel eats grass, leaves, etc. Okay, fine.
You have known about the camel, right? So this is the information about the camel. Okay. So dear friends, now you are going to learn some interesting words in this lesson. Okay. because if you learn these interesting words, those are helping you to read the lesson, right? So here are some only few interesting words. Okay, you can practice and you can pronounce that, and those are helping you to read the lesson. See, later I will read the lesson. So before that, I would like to introduce some interesting words. So listen carefully, everyone, because I'm going to tell one by one with the pronunciation. Okay. Okay, look here, children. Here are some interesting words from the third lesson. Okay, in this lesson only there are few interesting words. Already have known those words. Although I would like to tell these words. Okay, and you can observe the pronunciation of these words and you can listen very well. Look here, interesting words. First one, village. Village. See how to pronounce that word? Village. Next, camels. Camels. See how to pronounce that word? Camels. Rode. Road. Okay. So rode, road. Ride. Ride means they are going to ride the bike, horse, right? So for that word, action word is road. Okay. Rode, road. Second one. Next one, followed. Followed. See, follow plus ed, followed. How to pronounce that word? Followed. Next one. L-O-S-E, loose. See, how to pronounce this word? L-O-O-L-O-O. Z sound is Z, right? Loose. Okay, you don't say loose. Okay, that's not a loose. That is loose. Okay. Next one, T-U-R-N-E-D, turn. What is that? Turn. A-R-O-U-N-D, around. See, how to pronounce that word? Around. J-U-M-P-E-D, jumped. O-F-F, off. Jumped off. Okay, this is the present verb we are calling that. So, you can pronounce with the off also. Jumped off, jumped off. So, look here. I am going to read this once again. Listen very well. Interesting words. Village. Camels. Road. Followed. Loose. Turn. Around. Jumped off. Okay. So these are the interesting words from the third lesson. Fine. Dear students, now you have learned some interesting words, right? Very good. Okay. You can underline all these interesting words in your textbook and you can practice today. Okay. So now everyone must open your textbook and open the page number 28. Because I am going to read this lesson. Okay. You can observe the comma, full stop. Okay, question mark and exclamation mark, everything.
Lesson number 3, counting the camels. A man once had to go to another village with his camels. He took all his 10 camels along with him. He rode one camel, the rest followed him. Come to the second paragraph. On the way he stopped, he said, I must count my camels. I must not lose any. So, he turned around and counted his camels. There were just 9. He counted them again. There were just 9 camels. He counted again. Still, there were only 9. Oh dear, he cried. I have lost 1 camel. Next page. He counted again. And again there were only 9 camels. The man was very unhappy. He jumped off the camels he was riding and he counted once again. 1, 2, 3, 4. This time all the 10 camels were there. The man was very happy. He said, now I shall not ride. I shall only walk. When I ride, I lose 1 camel.
Okay, fine. Dear students, what have you learned in this class? So you have learned about some interesting words. And you have known how to pronounce that. And you have known about the camels. Okay. And you have read the lesson also. Isn't it? All these things you have learned today, right? So in your home, today you can draw the picture of camel and you can color it. Okay. And you can underline all interesting words in your textbook. And you can read the lesson also. And read the lesson properly. Okay. So tomorrow's class I am going to explain that counting the camels lesson. Okay, you can be ready to listen the class. So until you can keep practicing the lesson, have a nice day. Bye-bye.